Can you just state your name for the record for me?
Jazlyn Smith.
How do you spell that for me?
J-A-Z-L-Y-N.
Thank you.
This man took away my best friend. My dad was the most comedic, selfless, encouraging, understanding, and God-honoring person I have ever and will ever meet. He knew and understood me better than anyone else, and that we should have had so much more time together. Dad was supposed to be there to watch me graduate and move me into the college that we prayed I could go to. He was supposed to interview my first boyfriend and walk me down the aisle. He should be here when my brother and I each start our own family, and he should have been able to retire and finally write his book. Instead, Mom, Xander, and I are stuck here without him. Dad doesn't get to be here to watch me grow up. He will never get to meet the friends I've made at college that he prayed God would provide, since I'd be hours away from him for the first time. When I get married someday, I'm stuck looking at an empty seat where my best friend should have been able to sit. I will be forced to raise kids in the future without them knowing the person who would have spoiled them the most. And I am stuck with countless inside jokes that are now one-sided. I remember a specific thing my dad told me and my brother during one of our many times playing catch with him outside. We tended to get some good conversations in during these fun moments. He said, "I would trade all of our possessions for one more day with my dad." At the time, Xander and I were very young, and I recall thinking, really? All of our possessions? Where would we live? What would we eat or wear? And I really just didn't understand it. But I do now. And that is the kind of emptiness that this man left in our family. I would give every possession for another father-daughter Justice League lunch date, another ride home from youth group where we would have weekly discussions about life, another time teaming up to give a Bible lesson, another hour to sit in his room chatting about our days when he got home from work, another opportunity to hear him cheer at my performances in games, another Audie Murphy cowboy movie night, and another Bat Cycle obstacle course race. Anything to see his smile and hear his contagious laugh again. My dad was taken from us way too soon by a stupid, selfish act with infinite repercussions. But that doesn't mean that we don't know what type of man he was. And if I live my life even half as incredible as he did, then I would be thankful. He could make anyone and everyone laugh. He gave the best advice. He was the greatest teacher. And he was truly the best comedian to write a prose piece with for competition. But most importantly, Dad was always pursuing a deeper relationship with God, our Heavenly Father, which led him to plant seeds of the Christian faith everywhere he went. Dad and I had an inside joke about the day our laughter died. I have no idea where that came from, just another random sentence we started saying to make each other laugh. We would say it with so much extra drama and acting behind the phrase to enhance the comedy, and I'm sure that those who knew how we were around one another aren't surprised about this. But I remember thinking, on April 9th of last year, as I sat in that room in the hospital, that it honestly was the day my laughter died. But that's not true. I may have only gotten 18 years on earth with my best friend, but I know that I will get an eternity with him in heaven. And that is the truth that I and the rest of my family hold close as we navigate the rest of our days here without Dad.